Hello everyone, sanibonani, dumelang, apsheni, molweni, tobela, lochani. I hope you all good people out there. Welcome to 105 Online Channel. In this channel, we are bringing you celebrity news, entertainment news, and gossip celebrity news. If you are new into this channel, please subscribe and hit that notification button. Hey good people, today I am bringing you the latest news of Jacob Zuma. Jacob Zuma says his continued imprisonment is an egregious violation of international law. The Constitutional Court's apparent refusal to rescind its imprisonment order is an egregious violation of international law. The former president's lawyer told the court through the papers on Friday, 13 August 2021. They were responding with regards to the court's request for submissions on the implications of international law on Zuma's detention. The court is considering whether to rescind its order that he be imprisoned for contempt of court after he defied its order to attend the State Capture Commission. Former President Jacob Zuma was taken into custody on July 8, 2021 to begin a 15-month sentence. The court heard arguments on 12 July 2021 and reserved judgment. On 6 August 2021, it asked all parties to the case for legal arguments on whether it is obliged to consider the UN International Covenant on Civil and Political Rights when looking at the trial rights under the SA Constitution, as well as the right not to be detained without a trial. Section 39.1 of the Constitution says that when interpreting the Bill of Rights, courts must consider international law. In submissions filed on Friday, Zuma's lawyer Dalimpofu said the Concord was bound by the provisions of covenant, which was ratified by South Africa in 1998, and it was mandatory that the court consider it. He stated that one of the covenant's provisions was that an imprisoned person is entitled to challenge his imprisonment in court, and that this must be considered without delay. And when Zuma had applied for rescission of the contempt and imprisonment order, he specifically asked for interim order that he be released in the meantime, and the principles of covenant were applicable to that request. Dalimpofu also argued that by issuing directions, the court had made it clear that the obligatory duty to consider the ICCPR was not carried out when it held Zuma in contempt and sent him to prison. He said, apart from anything else, the failure to have done so constitutes a reasonable error and/or omission. The application out accordingly to succeed on this ground alone. Jacob Zuma has been in custody for over a month and will be eligible for parole towards the end of October. Do you agree with Jacob Zuma on this one? If not, why not? Please let me know on the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Please do not forget to subscribe and hit that notification bell so that you can get more news on this channel. 105 Online Channel loves you. Bye good people.